Good afternoon, everyone. My name is David Lynchehaun. I'm the Chief Revenue Officer of the Morson Group. Absolutely delighted to be here today to share our journey with Palantir and how AIP has really helped us to advance our company. So who are the Morson Group? I think it's always really important to try and understand where a company starts from. And this is the actual house where our late great founder, Jerry Mason, started the business back in 1969. And he started it specifically underneath these stairs where he had a small desk and a telephone. So moving forward, we've grown quite a bit since then. And we're now very proud to say we're one of the world's largest engineering and STEM recruiters, servicing different industries across the globe. Our group CEO, Jed Mason, the son of Jerry, has moved the business forward considerably over the last three, four decades. In terms of some pertinent facts and stats about the business, just to get a feel for what we do, at any one time, we'll have between 17 and 18,000 of our consultants out on assignments with clients. And we also have an in-house team of 1,300 engineers that sit side by side with our clients internally, helping them in terms of their products and solutions. Last year, we were acquired by the Canadian VC Onyx, and our mission together is to become the world's leading engineer and STEM recruiter. So as the slide says, we do operate in very similar worlds to Palantir, and it was a real nice natural synergy that we had when we first started speaking. But we serve multiple industries with different solutions for our clients, whether it's blue collar, white collar, managed service, training, statement of work, in-house talent, RPO, etc. So that's a very quick overview of the Morson Group. Let me tell you a little bit about why I'm stood on stage with you today. Firstly, and contrary to popular belief, recruitment is hard. I'm sure we've all had our fair share of experiences in the past, whether we've been the candidate or we've interviewed a candidate. But it's hard because recruitment has a myriad of different data points and has different factors that go into that recruitment process. There's an awful lot of structured and unstructured data that goes into the process itself. There's also a huge amount of administration that the consultants need to act upon to be able to find different candidates across different systems and what have you. And as you can see on the graph here, this demonstrates how many individual data points go into a single candidate. I did say it was hard. So when we talked to Palantir, we had three major things that we wanted to fix. Number one was enterprise search. How could we help our consultants to find candidates far easier? Second was that administrative overhead. There was an awful lot of time spent on low-value administration, emails, et cetera, et cetera. How could we alleviate that from the team? And lastly, we really wanted to ensure that we had a fair process when we were working with Palantir from an AI perspective. We didn't want any model drift, and we wanted to ensure that any job role that we had was matched against a candidate who had the best skills and the best experience. No PII data or what have you. So we jumped into a two-week trial with Palantir and a pilot. I worked very closely with the very talented Paul Roberts at Palantir UK. And we had the benefit of working with two of your forward deployed engineers who were great. And they literally, within a week, I think, sucked in around a million candidate CVs, all profiled, all searchable, full Ontology. And then they went a step further and helped us with our semantic search and really built something that was bespoke for us. We've managed to really automate an awful lot of the workflows that we had in place previously, and I'm absolutely delighted in terms of how we've moved forward. The results themselves, well, they really do speak for themselves. We've saved our recruiters a bunch of time every single day. I think that time saving has been absolutely critical. Saving our recruiters over an hour each day is huge. In a business like ours, where we have 600-700 recruiters, that equates to 56 additional full-time recruiters. So it's been a real game change for us, but it's helping us to help our clients and also ultimately make that process as seamless as possible. What I want to do now is give you a feel for what the system looks like, and the demo that you're seeing in front of you is going to come in two parts. The first part is what the recruiter sees. So what we're going to do here, we're going to add a job. We're going to add a job on the system and then submit that and put it forward. That then goes into the platform itself. And what we want to do is now refine, we want to drill down in terms of that capability. As you'll see, there's over 600,000 candidates there that's actually showing. But we want to really narrow that down in terms of the location. And we're now going to do a radius search to really help to hone in on available candidates. Now, that 600,000 figure has just dropped to 29,000. So we're really starting to narrow down in terms of what we're looking for from our candidates. We then enter some semantic search terms, and as you can see, that the system is now thinking. And it's brought back a short list of available candidates who are currently looking, who have indicated that they're interested in this type of role, and it's matched up. Now, we might want to go a step further and actually start to hone in on exactly what the client's looking for. So in this case, we're saying that they're looking for 2 years' experience, which is really important. What the system is doing now is giving us the top 20 candidates. So out of a pool of 29,000, it's gone down to 20. And that shows us the candidates who best match that role for the given opportunity. And it ranks them from a scale of 1 to 10 and also provides a rationale in terms of why that candidate is a great fit for our role. I mentioned the third challenge before, and that was around fairness and bias monitoring. We were really clear with Palantir. We worked very closely with their PCL, their Privacy and Civil Liberties team, to ensure that any role that we had and was worked was very much matched up against candidates who had the skills and the right experience. And that's constantly monitored and checked in the background. The last part of the slide is around our back-end system. So what you're seeing here is actually how the agentic agents are actually being deployed at the back-end. So the front end you saw earlier was around our recruitment consultants actually doing the inputting. What you're seeing here is the automation of our recruitment process. This is the game change for us. This is really helping to bring to life what agentic means for us. So what you're seeing here is the same job. It's a senior IT project manager, and we've got similar candidates who have been built up. And what's going to happen now is we're going to have multiple agents work on this recruitment process from end to end. So as you can see, the potential candidates are showing, the first 20, and that's going to get passed across to the next agent who's going to really narrow down in terms of top candidates. And then finally, it gets down to a shortlist where we can really hone in. Now, if you're a recruiter and you've got 20 jobs that you're working or 30 jobs, whatever it may be, if you can come in and you've already got predetermined candidates, it gives you more time to speak to the candidate. It gives you more human in the loop. Now, the consultant can go a step further and check the logic and really review whether the agent has picked the right CVs for that particular vacancy. Or they can just go ahead and send an email and get in touch with the candidate. So that's a bit about us. I'm really, really delighted to be able to share my story with you guys. It's been an absolute pleasure working with Palantir. And if I may, as a final thought, I think there's an awful lot of businesses out there that claim to provide AI, chatbots and the like. I think if you're looking to do something proper with AI, these are definitely the guys to speak to.